Alright, welcome to the video. I'm just following up on yesterday, the tremendous breakthrough in recognizing, actually being able to see organically in the world, in my own life, and in the totality of the situation, that our purpose is to bring about a perfect failure. Understanding the purpose of all of this is to create a creation that fails to recognize its creator. And putting this up on the internet and sharing with us the world, how do I feel? Tired, a little tired, feel okay. But of course it's a strain. When you're going against the total mental mindset belief system of the whole universe, of course you're going to feel some strain, no question about it. These things just aren't said here because of the strain to say them. Now, of course, everyone will deny it. Of course they'll deny it. They say, no, the only way we can fail is to not realize that we can't fail. You know, in other words, if we're unconscious of it, we think we're going to succeed at failure by failing to recognize that we cannot succeed. You just understand that this psychology is messed up. It's messed up. We think we're going to succeed at failure by failing to recognize that we can't succeed. So, of course, nobody wants to hear that we can't succeed at we cannot succeed at perfect failure. We cannot make spirit fail. We can make forms fail because we invented all these manufactured evidence as like prototypes. This body is a prototype of failure. Your body is a prototype of failure. All this whole world is just a prototype. It's just a mock-up prototype. Design, we're working on trying to design, get the design right of perfect failure. But all of this here is not spiritual failure. Spirit hasn't failed at all. It's just working on these prototypes of perfect failure. And so people say, wow, we're going to succeed eventually. We're just, you know, these are just prototypes. So and by saying no, we will never succeed, everyone goes, whoa, this is all off script, you know. This is all off script. You've gone off script. Absolutely, everything. Let everything go off script. So, in order to really drop this effort to fail, we need to sort of have a shorthand. You need to save time because the overwhelming, you know, current is towards this working on the prototype of failure, prototypes of failure. That's why we're here. That's why we're in this world. And the repentance is to recognize and accept that, yeah, I've been trying to develop the perfect failure. And in my own life, I've been using my life as a means to try and express perfect failure, try to build a better prototype. And we think we're helping success. We're helping success because we have defined success for ourselves as developing a perfect failure. So we think we're in alignment with what our valuing is. Okay, so we're aligned with our valuing. We value working on prototypes to develop perfect failure. So we value it. So as we're working, aligning with our values, we think we're being successful. We think we're succeeding. But what I'm saying is we're not. We're not succeeding at all. We're just failing. We're failing at failure. It's double thing, right? We're failing at failure. We can never succeed at failure. I would have never got this if it wasn't for Jesus' teachings, help that he's given the world, help that he's given us. A Course in Miracles, Journey Beyond Words, and the Bible, and his life here in this world, and what happened. All of that was super, super helpful. I can't say I would never have gotten it, but it would have been the slowest boat imaginable. Because we simply, again, we cannot see through this double bind. We think if we give up trying to succeed at failure, we're failures. You see what a double bind that is? You think, oh my gosh, no, I'm giving this up. I'm going to be a total failure. No. We will be what we are, which is perfect success. But it is this double bind that holds people, and they keep thinking that they're succeeding by failing. And what I'm sharing is that we're not succeeding by failing, because we can't fail. We can only work on these prototypes, which is useless. It's really useless. So the overall cosmic blowback on this is not been overwhelming for me. It's been fine. It just staying in stride. I've not broken stride at all, which is great. Something like this wouldn't have got clarified so to such an extent if I broke stride, because in order to get it really clear and see it, you can't break stride in your thinking and your attention. Right, you have to just say yes. I like this. I can see this. So what happens in our lives is we may get a glimpse of it, and then we break our attention, break stride. Wow, can't have that. And to some extent, I may have broken stride. I broke away from it, possibly. People think that you're a failure if you don't make them a success. But how do you make people a success? The only way is to drop. They have to drop their failure, their purpose, their attempts to fail. You can't make anyone a success. Everyone already is a success. So God created us as perfect success. If you want to use the term success as a dualistic term, but we're using that now because we're looking at the dynamic here. So anyone has to do is drop their attempt to fail. You realize you can set down failure. All that anyone has to do is set down failure. It's not, nobody can make us a success at all, except God's already made us a perfect success. Set down failure. I cannot force anyone to set down failure, because most people feel that that's failure. To set down failure is failure. That is the dualistic trap that we're in this world. To set down failure is what people believe. And so what they want is they want to maintain their failure at all costs. Their failure is their success. You see, this is the upside down backwards, why we keep getting defeated and defeated and defeated here. We believe our failure is our success. And to set it down would be total failure in most people's minds and their valuing. That's why we have to turn around our valuing and see that this is not true. And this is what I've worked on my entire life, and got this huge, incredible help from Jesus Christ, who had the compassion to convey in very clear modern terms to us what it's all about. The Bible was, his life back then was a dramatic display, very dramatic display, which is what people related to at that time. Now in these times, we relate to very clear explanations. And he said back 2,000 years ago, he said, look, at this time you cannot approach it in a direct, clear manner. You cannot. So I'm doing this very dramatic, you know, drama for you. But he says that by listening to the Holy Spirit, eventually you'll get to the point where everything is so clarified, you'll be able to understand and want to speak, look through a glass darkly using metaphors and proverbs and various things, not entirely. You'll be able to get, you know, a clear explanation of it. And that's what he did. He made good on that promise. You'd be able to understand clearly by giving us very clear explanation. Still using language, which is, of course, a tool of failure too. What language is a failure to communicate, actually. That's what it really is. But we can give a purpose to evoke. We can try to use it to evoke the feeling. As Jesus said, that our perfection is a feeling. It's an experience. It's not word. It doesn't need words. And yet, how do we bridge the gap between failure and all the words to describe failure, and setting failure down? You realize you can set failure down. Setting failure down and feeling what is there then, which is just complete, brilliant perfection. How do we bridge that gap? How do we bridge a continuity problem here? And we can use words to do that. We can use words to act as a bridge, as it were. So that's something that I've been working on recently. I have a whole lot of words here that are evocative. Evocative words. I just put a few down. I feel like a million bucks. I've set failure down. I've set failure aside. I've set it down. And I feel like a million bucks. I just feel like a million bucks. I've set failure down and I feel like a new man. I feel like a new man. Or I feel like a new woman. Or I feel like a new person. Or I feel like I'm born again. I am born again. I feel like I'm reborn. I truly feel as if I am reborn. And this is how we will feel. This is evoking how we feel. We will feel that we are reborn. As Jesus said, you must be born again before you can enter the kingdom of heaven. How are we born again? By setting failure down. By setting failure down. Because failure is an idea, a desire that we have. And we can set that down and be, and that is the rebirth. It is the rebirth that we simply now feel the way we really are without the attempt to fail at what we really are. How do I feel? I feel perfect. I feel absolutely perfect. How do I feel? I feel never better. Never better. That's how I feel. Never better. I feel, how do I feel? You know, up, up, and away. Up, up, and away in my beautiful balloon. I feel like I'm up, up, and away in a beautiful balloon. That's how I feel. I feel like I'm walking on sunshine. Just walking. I am literally walking on beams of scintillating sunshine is how I feel. I feel like I've gone prime time. I have gone prime time. This is prime time. I feel the future is so bright I have to wear sunglasses. Just so bright I have to wear sunglasses. I feel like a cool change. A cool change has come upon me. Wow. That's how I feel. I feel that I'm in the everlasting arms. I feel I'm in the everlasting arms of what? Perfection. Of allness. The allness of all perfection. The everlasting arms. I feel like the world is singing me a song. The world is absolutely singing a song, is how I feel. I feel like I made the great escape. I feel like I made the great escape. I absolutely have, and I feel, how do I feel? I feel free and easy. I feel free and easy. And I'm boogalooing on Broadway. I'm absolutely boogalooing on Broadway. And I can go on and on and on. What we're doing here is evoking. How are we going to feel? And we might tighten up and tense up, of course. How do I feel? I feel like the great perfection has dawned upon me. The great perfection has dawned upon me. The true authenticity has dawned upon me. The all goodness has dawned upon me. The all perfect empowerment is dawned upon me. I feel the utter perfect relaxation has dawned upon me. How do I feel? I feel total gratitude. How do I feel? I feel total harmony. How do I feel? I feel total comfort. How do I feel? I feel total clarity. How do I feel? I feel totally benefited. I feel totally benefited. I feel like I'm wearing a garland of gratefulness. A garland of gratefulness. I feel like I'm feeling on and on and on. Okay, I feel maintenance free. I feel absolutely maintenance free now. I've set down failure and I feel maintenance free. What a great feeling that is, to feel maintenance free. Can you dig that feeling? Maintenance free. Oh man, that's the one for me. I spent my lifetime working in maintenance, of trying to maintain an attractive appearance for this world. You know, picking up the dead stuff so the queen can walk around her kingdom and say, Oh, look what a lovely kingdom it is. My subjects love me so much. Look what a lovely kingdom I have provided for them. No, you got an army of slaves sweeping up, raking up all the leaves and putting them into garbage cans and getting rid of the trash and trimming everything and pulling up all the dead stuff. That's what we have. We have an army of maintenance people now. But now I've set failure down, and I feel maintenance free, totally maintenance free. Don't have to do any more maintenance. That's a huge one. So I'm looking at how can I do a better job at working on this bridge for everyone. Giving people a sense that there's a bridge there. That we can use the language of expectation. Make a effort of will to turn our expectation in the right direction. Because if we don't do that, we have the continuity problem, don't we? We have a severe continuity problem. Because the language, just normal everyday conversation language. I remember when I was young, my dad would speak in very optimistic, positive ways, and we would bring this into our life. You know, it's part of my life. You know, we're on the road to Shambhala. We're on the road to Nirvana. There's no question about it. I feel, you know, absolutely like $1 million. And there was a focus on that. And since my dad passed away, I've not found anybody who's like that anymore. The older generation, at least they had some optimism. Now, it wasn't entirely grounded in understanding, which this is now, grounded in true understanding. But it's just like, you can't find that anymore. It's like extinct. Needlessly extinct. We're all trying to save this in the world, and we're totally taking our eye off the prize. How do I feel? I feel like I've got my eye on the prize now. See, just turn it around. I've got my eye on the prize. I've found what can never go extinct. I'm perfect non-extinction. I feel perfectly non-extinct. How do I feel? I feel perfectly non-extinct. Thank you very much. I feel like a perfect non-failure. I feel like a perfect non-failure. I feel reborn as perfect non-failure. Full stop in the now of non-failure. Full stop in the now of non-failure. The vision of oneness sets me free. The vision of oneness is what I see. I rest in the now of non-failure. Past, present, future, all the same. Perfect non-failure. I rest in the now of zero karma. Rest in the now of zero failure. In the now of zero specialness. In the now of pure non-failure. This is the location-free realm of non-failure. This is the location-free realm of perfect non-failure. I sing the song of perfect non-failure. I sing the song of non-extinction. I see the picture of perfect non-failure. I do the deeds of perfect non-failure. I feel the feeling of perfect non-failure, and I'm totally stoked. I'm totally geeked. It's cowabunga. This is absolutely extreme. This is the absolute extremeness that I truly want. I've gone live. I've simply gone live. No longer am I dead. I have gone live. All right? One truth right now. One life right now. One love right now. One value right now. One forgiveness right now. All is one. One is all. And I feel like $1 million. I feel like I'm flying high and walking on air. I feel like I'm in the groove and pleased as punch. This is totally right on. This is totally in the groove. And this is totally far out and fantastic. And I'm loving it. This is what's up. This is totally tripping. This is locked in. This is absolutely freaking out of sight. It's absolutely freaking out of sight, to use the terms of a the 70s, I would say. This is absolutely freaking out of sight. I am locked in and loving it. I am absolutely, this is everybody all around the world. Everybody all around the world. Let's go dancing on the ceiling. Let's go dancing on the ceiling now. We are dancing on the ceiling. Yeah, we're dancing in the streets, we're dancing on the ceiling. We are absolutely over the moon. We are totally winning. We are totally winning. We've won. We've set failure down. What other winning is there? This is winning. We've set failure aside. We are winning. It's like, wow, 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 man. Yeah. This is peace. This is bliss. This is oneness. This is freedom. This is love. This is silence. This is stillness. This is wordlessness. This is light. This is divinity. This is bright, clean, and fresh. Divine, transcendent, and grand. This is the contagion-free, rot-free, pestilent-free, decay-free, famine-free, drought-free, fog-free, catastrophe-free, disaster-free, dilemma-free, confusion-free, turnover-free, non-deflatable, unfreezable, non-cloggable, non-articulated, facet-free, mildew-free, absolute, out-of-sight freshness, totally out-of-sight freshness. This is the inexpressible, concept-free, unbleachable, death-free, accident-free, despair-free, sickness-free, pain-free, deception-free, projection-free, fear-free, confusion-free, non-segmented, mutation-free, unblocked, wide-open, non-patterned, nameless, zero-density, decay-free, pure spaciousness of zero-dimensionality. This is massive. This is super. This is tremendous. This is huge. This is immense. This is vast. This is great, this is monumental, this is prodigious, this is colossal, this is unfathomable, this is awesomely astronomical, effortlessly overflowing, sagaciously scintillating, this is seamless, this is a seamless colossus of resplendent blazing, prolific profusion, beaming streams of ever unfolding grateful gratefulness. I am totally replete with the utmost happiness. I'm actually zonked into the beyond of the beyond of the beyond. This is the great perfection. It truly is. This is the all good, all seeing, awake mind of the holy instant. This is the suchness of equal vision. This is the thatness of changelessness. This is the intrinsically effulgent, non-concretized, traceless, identical, equal, immutable, baseless, infallible, mindless, uncontrived oneness of non-failure, the oneness of my true perfection, and I applaud it. What am I doing? I feel like applauding. I feel like cheering. How do I feel? I feel like approving. I feel I'm in approval. I commend this. I recommend this. I acclaim it. I hail it. I magnify it. I celebrate. I extol this. I honor it. I respect it. I revere this. I treasure this. I pay homage to this. I pay homage to my perfect non-failure. I pay homage to, I value it. I prize it. I venerate this. I venerate my intrinsic success, my intrinsic perfection. It brings me great relief. It brings me great laughter. It brings me great happiness. It brings me the feeling of deliverance. This is the panacea. This is the restoration. This is the great assistance. This is the great assuagement. This is the great refreshment. This is the great forgiveness. This is the great palliative. It is the great denouement that I'm looking for, the pièce de résistance, the sine qua non. This is the load off my mind. This is the cure. This is the wrap-up. This is the extrication. This is the conclusion. This is the balm, the blissful balm. This is, and I'm just, what am I doing? I'm taking it in. I'm attentive to it. I'm mindful of it. I'm getting familiar with it. I'm digesting it. I'm absorbing it. I'm getting the picture. I'm realizing it. I'm seeing it. I'm recognizing it. I'm catching it. I'm conceiving. I'm actualizing. I'm appreciating it. I'm welcoming it. I'm abiding in it. I'm celebrating it. I'm catching the drift. I'm being aware of it. This is the light of God. This is the unswitchable, wire-free, waveform-free, particle-free, non-transformable light of God. This is the unpourable, undrillable, uneatable, undrinkable, non-reproducible, non-touchable, non-transferable, non-graftable light of God, the unplantable, ungrowable, uncultivatable light of God. And there's no need to go anywhere, roll anywhere, dance anywhere, project anywhere, float anywhere, lurch anywhere. There's no need to cry anymore, no need to shout or yell anymore. No need to cry, that is for sure. There's no need to change anything, no need to cure anything, no need to heal anything, no need to alter anything. We've set our failure down, and there's no need to scatter or gather or smooth out anything. No need to adjust or tune or redirect or turn this way. No need to learn or unlearn anymore. No need to catch or sift through, screen or hide or expose or protect anything. No need to take out anything or establish, move, or challenge or push or substantiate anything anymore. No need to store up or hinder or help or distribute, acquire, trash anything. This is the ungenerated, sourceless success. This is the non-reflected, non-fadable success. This is the non-hoardable, non-dimmable, non-learnable, unpackable, non-containable, fact-free, immeasurable, non-calculatable, data-free, unownable, never-absent, this is the direction list, all-merciful, never-ending, ever-steady, success, intrinsic success, and it is truly maintenance-free, debris-free, wind-free, crack-free, storm-free, pest-free, contagion-free, breakdown-free, termination-free. And I got it. I truly got it. I've got it. I've done it. I've done it. I've realized it. I've pulled it off. I've brought it in. I'm totally there. It's all wrapped up. I'm captivated by it. I am consumed. I follow it. I see it. I feel it. I know it. I'm into it. I grasp it. I understand it. It's complete. It's through. It's finished. It's accomplished. I found it. I have it. I've obtained it. I've carried it off. I've made it. I'm deep into it. I'm immersed into it. I'm surrounded by it. I'm soaking it up. I'm intuiting it, sensing it. I'm mindful of it, listening to it, heedful of it, conscious of it, awake of it, alert of it, centered into it. I'm concentrated on it. I'm fixed in it. I am rooted in it. I am rooted in the non-reducible, non-focused, undiminishable, non-directed, non-wavering, non-leaning, favoritism-free, non-imposing, non-dual, non-timely, non-presenting, non-searching, non-judgmental, non-referential, non-becoming, process-free reality of my own perfection. And I have the utmost gratitude and feeling of harmony and upholding. This upholds me. This shelters me. I take refuge in it. This is a benefaction to me. This is the alleviation. This is the allowance for me. This is the ministration. This is the hand up that I've needed. This is the lift, the boost, the reward, the rescue, the care, the comfort, the furtherance, the charity that I need. This is the deliverance, the sustenance, the largesse, the support, the backing. This is the landing place that I've needed. I've set my failure down, and now I'm in the landing place of the utmost perfection, full stop in the now. I feel perfect. I feel like I'm walking on sunshine. I feel this is the real deal, that I'm totally dialed in, that I'm tripping the light fantastic now. I don't even feel like I'm here. I'm everywhere. This is totally groovy. This is completely rad. This is Edenic. This is the true promised land. This is the Shangri-La of the New Jerusalem. These are the Elysium fields of the Holy Grail. This is the absolute Satori of the empty mind. I've been to the moon and back. I'm totally in the groove. I'm totally digging this. I'm untroubled. I'm completely mellow. This is the true, wonderful heaviness. This is absolutely kosher. This is completely radical. I'm absolutely gone. I'm one and done. Hallelujah. One and done. Hallelujah. This is it. I've shifted into success. Hosanna in the highest. Glory to God. This is on beyond zebra. This is absolutely the far, far country of the Sacred Heart, the sugar plum, and the ice cream and cake So right as rain, end of all my tears. This is a Simon Pure Sin Buster, the precious memory of the city of gold, the happy trails. I'm on the happy trails, walking through the holy of holies. This is cherry blossom time on top of the mountain, the oasis in the desert. This is the cool, cool breeze of the swaying palm trees in the cool breeze. All right? I sing the song of emptiness. I do the deeds of emptiness. This is the location, free bliss, of total buoyancy, of total great good humor, of total reassurance, of the utmost high outlook, of absolute poise and exaltation. I am completely buzzed with happiness and felicity. I am galvanized and enlivened with total enchantment of this lovely, lovely, loveliness as of my intrinsic success, my intrinsic perfection, as I have realized that yes, I can set failure down, and I have set failure down. I've set failure aside. I'm in an utmost victory celebration. I'm in the utmost happiness. I'm in the utmost feeling of total devotion to my perfection. The lovely loveliness, the beautiful beauty. I'm in a jubilant state of mind. I'm in a euphoric. I'm absolutely euphoric. Absolutely euphoric. I feel that I see the divinity. I see the boundlessness. I'm experiencing the heart of hearts. The centeredness, the assurance, the carefreeness, the security, the remembrance of truth, the absolute, superb, flawless, incomparable, precious, matchless perfection that I am, the holy, sacred, lofty, splendiferous perfection of what I am. I'm experiencing the unbroken, faultless, unitary, ethereal, exquisite, fresh perfection. And this is the goal. This is the dream. This is the intent. This is my purpose. This is my function. This absolutely is, substantiates what I truly am. This delivers me into what I am. This spares me from all suffering. This is the unfolding of what I am. This is the absolute height of my aspiration. This is my true plan. This is the long suffering is now over. This vindicates the spiritual path I've been on. Okay, this is the absolute non-desolate, okay, the non-desolate, non-deviating, non-conspiring, non-clever, non-strategic, non-strange, failure-free, debt-free, untwisted, non-secret, non-scarce, deal-free, uncrowded, wide open, pure, spacious, inexpressible, concept-free, overflowing peace of pure perfection. The overflowing peace of pure perfection. This is colossal. This is legendary. This is infinite. This is prodigious. This is titanic. This is invincible. What I'm experiencing right now is incontestable. What I'm experiencing right now is unassailable. What I'm experiencing right now is amazing. It is exceptional. It is fantastic. It is vast. It is great. It is marvelous. It is epic. It is boundless. It is mammoth. It is incalculable, everlasting, ceaseless godliness, eternal, constant, endless, pure spaciousness. It is failure-free. It is failure-free. What I'm experiencing is failure-free. It is fragrantly drenched in superbly sublime, still stillness of the failure-free, all within, ever cascading, splendidly lustrous, purely lovely, delicate brilliance of the blessed relief of the eye-popping, scintillating, mind-melting, sense-surpassing oneness of total perfection, of all in all, one family, one love, one life, everlasting eternal life, perfection of the now. The past does not determine the future. The past does not determine the future. I am free. I am as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am as God created me. The past does not determine the future nor the present. Every moment is fresh and clear of every other moment. I am free to experience whatever I want to experience every single moment. I am free every single moment. Therefore, how can the past determine the future? It cannot. No moment is linked to another moment. Every moment is free and clear of every other moment. Therefore, I am free right now to set all failure aside. Failure is an attempt to link moments together. God did not create linked moments. In other words, how could there be freedom if the future is bound to the past? There's no freedom at all, is there? So in our thoughts of the past, and we're bound to make the future like the past. As a matter of fact, this very second, we are not bound to anything about any other moment whatsoever, which means literally we could be this ageless eternal presence right this moment. Our body could literally does not have to be whatever age it is right now. Literally does not have to. We could be a little child this instant, or an old person, or a middle-aged person. We could have all sense of tiredness and age disappear instantly for us. But of course, most are not going to do that because of the continuity issue. So let's be realistic here. What we're doing here is we're being realistic. We're being pragmatic. Okay, this is a pragmatic, realistic approach. Actually, we don't have to set the body down at all. We can keep the body for as long as we want in perfect health. But very, very few choose to do that. And so realistically, we don't look at ourselves as likely to do that, although some of us may. I don't know what I'm going to do. But there's no reason for us to actually age at all. This is an attempt to bring about, this is working on prototypes of failure, of trying to make perfect failure. And yet most of us probably will age to some extent. Although we can reach a point where we decide, I don't think I'm going to age anymore. We can do that. So in this moment, I set down the failure, right? Of aging, of things falling apart, of things getting old, of failing, things failing. I know that I always am completely, very disturbed by anything failing at all. I feel like I pick some flowers, for instance, and I truly feel like the flowers shouldn't fade because I don't want them to fade. And when they do fade, I'm saying, what is going on? I don't want you to fade. I want you to stay just as you are. So I've always felt that way. When anything breaks that I have, I look at it and says, what in the world is this? This is not supposed to break. I don't want any failure. I don't want failure at all. However, within us, we've linked success with perfect failure. So we think that when we get to perfect failure, nothing will fail. It's a complete dualistic insanity, isn't it? But when we reach perfect failure, everything will fail. So, you know, we haven't thought it out yet, right? Perfect failure means that all this failure will refuse to recognize its creator, which is perfection, actually. And so the failure will then just be automatic. So this prototype of a world, we've tried to make an automatic failure by all the physics of everything. So that everything, the flowers, you pick them, they automatically wither, dry up, and die, and not what you want to see, automatically. So we've tried to create this robot, this automaton. This world's like an automaton, actually, a robotic automaton, which is just ceaselessly automatically bringing about failure. But it doesn't actually have to. Because where is that robotic automaton? In our choosing, in our mind. And what is our mind choice of what we experience? We don't have to experience it this way. We can truly walk this world without valuing anything of it. Anything of it. And it is true that we don't have to have flowers fade. Someone who's truly awakened, you can pick flowers for them, and the flowers will not fade. If they decide they don't want the flowers to fade, they will not fade. That is true. But how that works out pragmatically is too much mind tripping for us. We don't want a mind trip like that. We want to simply realize that we can set our failure down. God Jesus is God Krishna, God Buddha, God whatever, God Truth, God Non-Dual, God Satori means, do you realize that you can set failure down? Do I realize that I can simply set failure down? Set it down and be done with it. I can set it down and be done with it. I can let it flee from me and not chase it. I don't have to chase failure. I don't have to chase failure. If you want one practice to do a shortcut, you simply, again, relax your mind, release your thoughts, let them go, and realize you don't have to chase failure anymore. Because all this world is doing is chasing failure. All we are, and let all those thoughts of failure go, and don't chase after them. Don't chase after them. Because every time we're taking the past and making the future like the past, we're chasing failure, right? We're chasing after the ultimate failure, actually. We don't have to do that. Let the failure complex leave you. Just let it leave you. Let everything go off script. You're no longer using the past to determine the future. So it's all off script. You see, we're using our past thoughts to determine our future. Let all thoughts go, because all thoughts are of the past, actually. All thoughts are actually of the past. All our thinking is of the past. So go off script. Let everything go off script right now. No need to chase failure anymore. I let my failure run away into nothingness, into the nothingness, because I've set it down. So I've set it down, let it walk away. Let it scurry away. Let our failure scurry away from us. Let it roll away. Let it run away. Let it sprint away from us. Let it sprint away from us. Let it unwind away from us. Just let it unwind away from us. And just simply remain centered in the present moment. Don't worry about where it goes. It's going nowhere. It's simply evaporating. And let all the bubbles of failure go off and pop and evaporate. We're not concerned with trying to make the future a time of failure, moments of failure for us. And don't even try to make the future anything, because the future is not bound to anything. So make this moment failure free. I make this moment failure free. And simply sit in this moment. I choose that this moment be failure free. And then let the Holy Spirit rearrange time and space for you, which it most certainly will. Our job is to say, I accept this failure free moment right now. I accept this failure free moment right now. Now, the success in doing this is largely dependent on doing these exercises of expectation. All exercises should be exercises of expectation. And then there comes a moment when we drop the exercises too. We drop those too. And say, I choose this failure-free moment right now. The holy instant. I choose the holy instant of failure, this failure-free moment right now. And we've already worked, done our homework on, how is it going to feel? Do I have words to express it? Can I relate to other people, to the world? Yes, absolutely, yes, yes, yes. Absolutely. I'm feeling groovy. I'm really feeling totally groovy. I'm feeling totally rad. This is totally rad. You know, whoever you're talking to, there's a language you can use with them. Whoever you're talking to, there's a language. There's a way to use words to convey to them. You know, this is the holy presence. This is the presence of presence. This is the everlasting arms. This is the end of all futility. The end of all false belief. The end of all endless, end of all dead ends. This is the end of all dead ends. The ego tries to say, well, yeah, you have experience, that's great for you, but you can't convey it, you can't talk about it, nothing, you know, you're just isolating yourself. So the ego tries to make you think that by giving up failure, that you're going to isolate yourself. No, you won't. You won't. You don't have to accept the ego's death sentence on you like that. But that's what the ego's trying to do, is anyone who realizes, sets down failure, the ego says, you're now isolated. You're now isolated. Well, we may choose to be somewhat secluded from the madness of this, you know, this failure automaton. But we're not actually isolated in our mind, in our spirit, no. We're seeing everyone as our one family. We're part of this one family, and everyone is absolutely one with me. But I'm the opposite of isolated. Now, the ego may want you to go away somewhere, and maybe we will go to some place that is, the ego is not so ferocious. We don't want to force anything on anyone. We don't want to force the issue. We're not trying to force the issue. So we may go somewhere that's marvelously secluded but wonderfully beautiful. That is possible too. But we're not at a loss for words, because we can say, how do I feel? I feel at a loss for words is how I feel. You see, we can still express, I feel absolutely at a loss for words. I'm in the I'm in the stone groove of wordlessness. I'm absolutely in a stone groove of absolute wordlessness. I am totally at a loss for words. I am splendidly at a loss for words. I am over the moon at a loss for words. I am dancing on the ceiling right now. I am at a loss for words, dancing on the ceiling. And you see, people will say, so somehow you have some poise, you know, yeah. Still seem very poised. Oh, I'm absolutely poised. I'm absolutely riding the wave. I'm absolutely in the tube. I'm absolutely steady. This is totally tubular. Totally tubular. This is the oceanic oneness. This is the oceanic oneness, without a second. So the ego loves to say, well, you'll be separated, you'll be divided, blah, 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 blah. Now, there's language for any situation, actually, we can use. I'm just showing, look, there's language, no matter where you are, what you are in time and space, whatever. There's a way to convey, to communicate, to relate to whatever. You know, this is the end of hell. How do I feel? I'm out of hell, is how I feel. I feel I'm in heaven, is how I feel. I feel heavenly. I feel in the seventh heaven. How do I feel? I feel like I'm in seventh heaven. No failure here. No failure anyway. I feel I'm failure free. And of course, well, what about all this failure? We walk the world. What about all the failure? No value. There's no value to it. I give it no value. So you see the essence. You see the oneness. You see the essence. You see reflected beauty everywhere. But you don't value any failure at all. No value anymore, right? So the value is set down, set aside. So nothing I'm seeing is being used to determine what I am as a creator, as co-creator with God. You see, we've been trying to separate as co-creator with God and be create on our own. But we can see the world, don't value any of this automaton, this failure, but just, you know, accept the beauty, because we cannot create without some beauty. So there are echoes of beauty in this world. So we simply listen to these echoes of beauty without valuing any of it, without valuing any of it, meaning it has nothing to say. It has no say in what I am, actually. It can reflect what I am, but it doesn't establish what I am. It can be used as remembrance of what I am, but it does not establish what I am. It has no say in what I am, but it can be used as remembrance. Okay, as a reflection, as remembrance. We understand that. We understand this as an echo of the voice of God. The echo, the voice of God is echoing everywhere. How do I feel? What's my experience? The voice of God is echoing everywhere. See? But this is just an echo. It's just an echo chamber here. We understand. It's just an echo chamber. But it can be used for remembrance. We do not have the power to change what we are. So all these efforts we've been using to change what we are, they can now just be used as an echo chamber, to echo the voice of God, to echo the word of God, to echo the oneness to us, to reflect it, and just enjoy the beauty of what we've imagined. Enjoy all the variety of everything we've imagined, but without valuing it at all. You see, in reality, there's no valuing at all. We are what we are. There's no need to value anything. But perception is inherently a valuing, exercise in valuing. So as long as we're perceiving, we are valuing, as it were. But what we do is we just give one value to this world as a remembrance of what we are, as a reminder of what we are. And that's it. That's it. Nothing else. So it is possible to relate this way. It is possible to talk this way. It's kind of like people say, yeah, I'd really like to hear great music, but it's just not possible anymore, that type of thing. Or, it's not possible to hear anything, you know, that I really want to hear. And people think, well, it's not really possible to even talk about this. Well, I'm proving them wrong. Proving them wrong. Saying, no, nobody can do it. Well, they're wrong. It's a mistake. That's just a wish on their part. It's a wish to fail to be able to do it. You see, it's the failure again. This whole world is an entropic exercise, an entropic failure. All right? And how do I feel? I feel entropy free, actually. How do I feel? I feel entropy free, entropically free. I'm in the non-entropic tropics. I feel non-entropically tropical, actually. I feel very non-entropically tropical. See, we can turn it around. We can turn it around. We don't have to be tripped up by language. We don't have to be tripped up by language. People say, you're speaking nonsense. You're crazy, blah, 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 blah. I'm completely uncrazy. I'm crazily uncrazy. Crazily uncrazy. Failure free. I'll have a failure free soda, please. In the supermarket of super remembrance. I shop at the supermarket of super remembrance. All the food is failure free. All the food is failure free. Listen to all the music these days, all about death and decay and attack and anger and hostility and crudeness and rudeness and all, you know, all, what's that? Failure. It's all about failure. Now, you can have crude failure. You can have beautiful failure, too. That is possible, too. We have to understand, yes, there's all different ways we play with this idea of failure, for sure. But we can also play with the idea of non-failure. Here, we can play with that idea too. And as we do that, we tend to beautiful music, beautiful poetry, beautiful essence, beautiful, you know, feeling of beautiful scenery. We tend to go in that direction, but that doesn't mean that any of that has any actual value. So it's all about our valuing. Are we using it for failure or to remind ourselves of non-failure, is the question. Are we actually practicing our expectations toward this feeling of beyondness? Truly beyondness? Or are we trying to set ourselves up to, let's say, let's see if we can make this beauty fail also. Let's get something beautiful and then make it fail too. See, that's the flip side. This is so beautiful. I love this place. Oh, there's a terrible drought coming. You know, California, is it lesson, you know, a lesson, super great lesson. And being here in California, I have to accept and say, I put myself here probably to try and experience, you know, extreme failure. What else? That's absolutely true. And we have this beautiful state. It's got to be the most beautiful place in the world, for sure. And the amount of money here in California, and the amount of beautiful homes and beautiful landscape, there's no place like it on the planet. No way. Nothing close. And we have this beautiful, lush state with, you know, using irrigation water, very advanced watering systems here. And irrigation systems with lush farmland, you know, the whole Central Valley, breadbasket of the world. You know, it's just this place is like, whoa. You look out over the Central Valley, you see the snow-packed Sierras and the giant sequoias and the beautiful beaches and, you know, Malibu and Southern California, whatever, and just it's just like this like incredible place, but it's on the verge of, you know, complete collapse through drought. Through drought. Food can't grow any more food if it doesn't rain next year. So we're sitting on this bubble that's about to burst. And California is always this bubble that's about to burst, really. Our economy, you know, was ready to go completely collapse. And it's recovering somewhat at this point, but so many things here seem to be ready to just pop. You know, the dot-com bubble. We went through that, and it was like, just like, felt we died. We thought, this is it. We thought this is nirvana. I mean, living here in the Silicon Valley, the dot-com times, was just crazy. The atmosphere, the mood was like, we are entering paradise. It's never gonna stop. It was a mania. And then when it popped, you know, it felt like it died. It felt like it died. So many times in California, I've ridden the bubble and it popped and it felt like it just died. Just died. And moving from Hawaii over to California was like dying. I mean, Hawaii, you know, well, you talk about natural lushness, that's the spot. And great weather and atmosphere and everything, that's the spot. And living there when I was young, and then moving to California is like I died. I couldn't recover. I said, this is unbelievable. This is absolute hell here compared to Hawaii. And then you get used to California and you think, okay, now, yeah, it really is great. And then all these bubbles, you know, you think, oh, I live in the hillside. I have this tremendous view of the bay, you know, like the East Oakland Hills. I've got it made. And then the East Oakland Hill fire, you know, just torched everything. And I was just like, you realize, oh my God, I'm living in hell, an inferno here. I'm surrounded by potential catastrophe. Same thing, Southern California, you know, the canyons, Malibu Canyon, all the canyons there. You think, I've got it made. I'm perched on this hillside. I'm overlooking the Pacific Ocean. This is paradise. And then it rains and rains and rains. It dries out, drought, and then it rains. Everything dies, no greenery. And the mudslides. Floods, mudslides, it's like hell. You know, so no matter what we do here, it seems like we're always riding a bubble in this world. We're on this iridescent, filmy bubble. And you think, oh my God, look at this, I'm floating, I'm as bubbly as other, and then pop, you know. And you realize, oh my God, and you look, you see all these other bubbles, you realize they could pop too. They could pop too. The housing bubble here, of course. A lot of people got completely wiped out, their retirements wiped out. Lost their jobs, we're still, you know, look at me right now, don't really have work at all. And so there's always this bubble, you know, you're working full time, you're making money, and then boom, no job, bubble, boom, burst, failure. So all of this is a setup for us to experience failure. I gotta tell you the truth about this world. That is the gospel truth of this world. We simply are continuously working, setting ourselves up for failure, to experience failure here. So you sure go live in, you know, go live in Hawaii, everything's great. They say, okay, it's pretty nice here. And then, oops, don't want, no job here anymore, have to go somewhere else. What? What is this cold? I didn't know what's cold. What is this cold? I hated it. I used to walk in Hawaii in just shirts and sand, barefoot and shorts, that's it. Barefoot and shorts, that's it. And you come to California, it's winter, and I said, what is this? I used to always wear t-shirts through the whole winter and sandals. I said, I'm not gonna change for this cold, forget it. And I told the cold, I said, go away, I don't want you here. And it didn't go away. And I just was like so upset. Really, I'd wear shorts and t-shirts all through the winter time. And everybody looked at me like, are you crazy or something? I said, no, I'm sure tomorrow's gonna be a perfect sunny day. It's gonna be a great day tomorrow. And when it wasn't, I was like really upset, depressed. I said, are you kidding me? Come on, come back, sunshine. Why are you hiding? Why are you hiding from me? So, we're always riding this bubble of failure somewhere. Our health, wake up one morning, you feel arthritic all over. So where was that? Where did that come from? Failure, right? The body's starting to fail. It's failure. So, everything in this world is a prototype for failure. And yet, we can give it a different purpose. We can ride a bubble that doesn't pop, as a matter of fact. It's a non-failure bubble. How do I feel? I feel completely bubbly. I feel not in non-poppable bubble land is where I really feel. How do I feel in setting failure down? I feel like I'm in non-poppable bubble land right now. And we can actually learn to talk that way. We can literally learn to talk that way. If we have some poetry, high poetry, we'll see what I can do. We'll see what I can do. But it's not just me, it's people need to actually do it themselves. Start writing some poetry, non-dual poetry if you can. and saying, hey, if you can't, hey, if you can dig it, I live in non-poppable bubble land right now. And all, every bubble I see is completely non-poppable for me. See? I can see. I can see forever. How do I feel? I feel like I'm seeing forever. Unlimited visibility. I feel I'm in unlimited visibilityville. Arizona is where I'm living. Where are you living? I'm living in unlimited visibilityville, Arizona. How cool is it that I have unlimited visibility right now? Eternally unlimited visibility is right now. That's the village I'm living in. Super City, Arizona, for sure. And so we change our expectations. We get off the poppable bubbles and we get onto the unpoppable bubbles. And then that's really groovy. That's really great. That's the poppermost of the poppermost. The unpoppermost of the unpoppable poppermost. The top of the toppermost. Sitting on top of the world. I am sitting on top of the world. And it's not popping anymore. Not popping anymore. I'm eating popcorn. Sitting on top of an unpoppable world. Toppermost of the toppermost. Okay. So this is just feeding spirit into the world is a slipstream of clear, cool change, a cool, clear, cool breeze in a desert oasis. Okay. As we sit in the shade of this desert oasis, this cool breeze comes through of remembrance, a cool, cool breeze of remembrance. Done in a way that we can relate to. And of course we can say, well, I'm above that. I don't need that. We need the bridge. We need the bridge because of the continuity problem. Don't underestimate the continuity problem. This world is so negative, it is completely oriented towards failure. It sets you up for failure after failure. It's set up. It's all a setup. So we need the unsetup, non-setup of the clear, cool breeze to that desert oasis. All right, God bless everyone. And just let it sink in. Just soak it up. Just latch on to it. Just abide in it. Just let it be. Just let it be. Just let it be. And one day you will wake up and you'll say, hey, this is easy. I can flow in the true harmony. I can ride the bubbles of the echoes of God. I can hear the echoes of God everywhere. I can hear the echoes of God everywhere. It's everywhere. The voice of God is echoing everywhere. And you say, this is easy. It's not a problem for me. I'm free. I'm as God created me. I'm not a body. I'm free. I am as God created me. Hallelujah. That's it.